Later this month, Ohio commemorates the first anniversary of a school shooting that took the lives of 3 students and injured 3 others at Chardon High School. I was there for a couple days. The principal, the superintendent, the teachers, the guidance counselors, the staff. What a privilege for me to be able to have a chance to spend time with them and learn from them. They're unbelievable. It's not easy there, even today. It's still tough. And they're trying to put the pieces back together. Some of the pieces are gone. We know they're never going to be quite the same. I went there and I could sit there with them because, as many of you have in this auditorium, I've looked in the black hole. The tragic and sudden death of my mother and father put me there. But I've healed. The Lord's grace has healed me. And when I pray for this great, incredible group of people, and when I think about the staff and the students, some of whom are still struggling, and I think about the people of Chardon, I pray they're going to heal. They're going to heal. They're going to, because they are tough and compassionate and smart. They're going to make it. But what courage they showed on that fateful day, and what courage they've shown ever since. It was appropriate to honor today with the Governor's Courage Award those leaders, those staff members who've worked day and night to bring peace, to bring understanding to all the people of Chardon, so that at the end of the day, those killings and that shooting will not be lost in vain. It's going to make them somehow, through the tragedy, better for it. But we will remember those who have lost their lives and those who have been injured, and we'll pray for them. But in the meantime, I'd like to take a second to honor the great staff from Chardon High School for their great work. How about all the winners, huh? How about all the winners?